Today, we'll be talking all about one of the most raved about powders in Japanese beauty. Keep on watching. What's up, kings and queens? It's Aiden, and welcome back, or welcome to my channel if you guys are new. I recently picked up the Can Make Marshmallow Finishing Powder after reading so many amazing reviews online and just wanting to try more Asian products and support more Asian brands. This is not really a first impressions just because I did swatch and play with it a little bit yesterday. You know, gotta check for allergic reactions. Some of you are just a little too quick to let that nice lady at the makeup counter swipe shit all over your face and then cry 3 hours later because you're breaking out in hives.
Can I lie? Can I fucking lie?
But anyways, back to the product. So you get 10 grams of product with this powder, and it retails for 940 yen, which is about $12 Canadian or $8 USD. It comes in 4 shades, and I'm in the shade matte beige ochre, and it's also currently the darkest shade. It has SPF 26, which is great for reapplying that sun protection throughout the day, but although it has SPF, it does not flash back. I tested it, and it's 100% photo friendly, which is necessary in this Instagram world we live in, okay? The ingredients of this powder makes me feel like it's going to be great for those of you guys who have dry skin. According to the website, it has squalane, olive oil, grapeseed oil, and aloe vera leaf extract. The website also claims this powder makes your skin look like a marshmallow, makes the appearance of pores and uneven skin tone less noticeable, and prevents shine. The powder itself doesn't have a fragrance, which is great for those of you guys who have sensitive skin, but it is also so finely milled. Like, it is silky soft to the touch. Like, I don't know if you guys can see that, but it is amazing. Hello. Hi. So I just zoomed you guys in because I really want to show you guys what this powder can do. You guys need to try this because it literally soft focuses your face, okay? All I do is I just take a brush, I swirl it around, I get a little bit of product, tap off the excess, and then just start to swirl across my face. And I can really tell what they mean by minimizing the appearance of pores and uneven skin texture, because literally it just soft focuses everything. And if you guys have pores, you just take the brush and you just push the product into that area, and it immediately, instantly smooths everything over and just minimizes everything. Like, I even have a breakout today, and for some reason, I can just push this on and it doesn't create any attention to that area. Like, it's crazy. Like, I don't know if you guys can see, like, I have a breakout right here. I'm just gonna put it right on here, and it just diffuses everything. As you guys can see, it's a natural matte finish. It's not too drying. I have a little bit of flaky skin going on around my nose today because of my allergies, and it doesn't seem to cling at all, which is going to be amazing for those of you guys who have super dry skin, okay? I've read some reviews online talking about the lack of coverage when it comes to this powder, and I feel like some people don't understand the concept of a setting and finishing powder. Like, this is not supposed to give you full coverage or cover up your imperfections. That's more of like a powder foundation. This is the last step before you walk out that door, just to seal everything in, so over your foundation, blush, bronzer, highlighter, whatever. And this powder doesn't have enough pigment and color in it to change the tone and shade of your face, which is what you want in a setting powder slash touch-up powder, because throughout the day, you don't want to be getting darker and darker and darker, or heavier and heavier and heavier as the day progresses, you know? You'll love this powder if you're on the drier, normal, combination oily side. I don't know if it would be as amazing on oily skin, but you can definitely take it with you and touch up. You don't have to worry about this powder because it is so finely milled. It's not gonna cake or bunch up on your skin. The packaging is like a back and forth love-hate relationship. I don't know what it is. It, like, on one hand, it gives me like Sailor Moon vibes, which is like super cute and super adorable. And on the other hand, it just kind of looks like cheap and childish. I don't know. Maybe if it was like gold all over, or maybe if it had a little bit more weight to it. I don't know. But I'm just like, don't know how I feel about this packaging, but it does come with a mirror and a puff, so it's great for touch-ups on the go, and it's pretty thin as well, so you can just throw it in your purse or your makeup bag, and you don't have to worry about it taking up so much room, because I know for myself, I carry and wear a lot of makeup, so my makeup bag can get pretty chunky really quick, and having something like this, it just is, you know, space efficient. Okay, rating wise, I'd give this product an 8.5 out of 10. For the formula and the price, it's just an amazing solid everyday powder. I did take some points off for the packaging and the shade range. Although it's a finishing powder and it's not for coverage, this being the darkest shade will have some of you, or most of you, looking ashy and casket ready real quick.
Like this.
But what are some of your favorite Asian products? Sound off in the comment section below, because who knows, maybe that will be the next product I review. So make sure you guys click that subscribe button and ring that bell to make sure you guys are up to date on future posts. And in the meantime, make sure you guys follow me on my Instagram at Aiden's Choice, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.